In this video, I'm going to discuss about the electrophilic addition to alkenes under the chapter Acyclic Hydrocarbons. That's a chapter 5 pulled out from the degree first semester syllabus. The whole chapter has been uploaded in my YouTube channel. The details have been given in the description box below. Do subscribe my channel. Let's see this now, electrophilic addition to alkenes in this in detail. The catalytic hydrogenation of alkenes have been discussed in my previous video. Now, the alkenes, we know these are unsaturated compounds. This is an olefin, that means having more than one double bond, one or more double bonds. Here, because of the presence of the double bond, we know that it's electron rich, so it can easily undergo the electrophilic addition reactions. Now, this acts as a nucleophile because it's electron rich, and then the electrophile can attack on this, resulting in the formation of an electrophilic addition products. So the pi bond, which is now in between these two carbon atoms, which is loosely held, now can act as a nucleophile and then undergo this electrophilic addition reactions. Now this pi bond, which is present here, is converted into a new sigma bonds, resulting in the formation of an alkane here. So it tries to form the more stable compounds by electrophilic addition reactions, resulting in the formation of new sigma bonds here. So the pi bond is converted into a new sigma bonds here and is undergoing the electrophilic addition reactions. Let's see this mechanism in detail now. First one is the pi electrons attacks the electrophile. So this nucleophile, now it's acting as a nucleophile, then attacks the electrophile, resulting in the formation of an carbocation here. This is a carbocation. Yeah, this is a carbocation, resulting in the positive charge of this. And if this is unsymmetrical alkene, we are taking this an unsymmetrical alkene, it attacks the electrophile in such a way that it produces the more stable carbocation. So the attack will take place, resulting in the formation of a more stable carbocation. And now this carbocation with a positive charge on one of the carbon atoms, now the nucleophile will attack this positively charged carbon in the second step, resulting in the formation of this alkane, that is addition product. Now this is obtained here, forming a stable addition product. So the carbocation is formed in such a way that it's more stable. If we take this alkene to be unsymmetrical, the carbocation which is formed is more stable. This is the one thing which is to be remembered here. And depending upon the stability of the carbocations here, this intermediate is being formed. And in the next step, the nucleophile will attack this positively charged carbon, resulting in the formation of this addition product, that is the alkane here. Yes, this is the mechanism which is followed here. Now let's see the orientation of this addition in the double bond. When we take this double bond, I've already said that if we take an unsymmetrical alkene, the addition takes place in such a way that a more stable carbocation is produced. And if an unsymmetrical alkene is taken, the more than one product is formed, but in unequal amounts, and which is formed in major and which is formed in minor amounts can be predicted based on this Morkonikov's rule. So the Morkonikov, the scientist, has proposed a mechanism to predict the formation of the product when the addition is taking place to the unsymmetrical alkenes, which is major and which is minor. For example, when we are taking this propene as an example, for the addition of this HBr to this, just this is an example. So the first thing, the electrophilic attack will take place, attack of the pi bond and the electrophile, resulting in the formation of a carbocation here. Here we see that this is a secondary carbocation. If the attack is taking place, then this results in the formation of primary carbocation. And if the attack is taking place here, the H plus is adding here, then the secondary carbocation is produced. As is, we know that the order of the stability of the carbocations is tertiary is more stable than secondary, then comes primary. So as a secondary carbocation is more stable, then this carbocation is formed in major amounts when compared to that of the primary carbocation, and the nucleophilic attack in the second step will take place on this carbocation, that is a secondary carbocation, resulting in the formation of 2-bromopropane as a major product here rather than 1-bromopropane. So let's see the mechanism in the next slide. But so in order to predict the predict which alkene is formed in major amounts in the case of unsymmetrical alkenes, Morkonikov has proposed a rule which is called as the Morkonikov's rule. What does this rule say? This rule says that so the electrophile acts in such a way that it produces a more stable carbocation. In the first step, the electrophile, which is H plus here, acts in such a way that it produces a more stable carbocation. And in other words, we can say that the negative part of the addendum, that is the of the attacking reagent, will goes to the carbon with less number of hydrogens. So that, in other words, a more substituted carbon here, the secondary carbon here. So this is a secondary carbon. It's more substituted or having less number of hydrogens. Only one hydrogen here. We have two hydrogens here. So the negative part of the addendum is going to the secondary carbon because it is having less number of hydrogens, or it's more substituted. In other words, it's more substituted, having more number of substituents or less number of hydrogens. So the negative part of the addendum adds to the carbon atom with less number of hydrogen atoms. This is what is Morkonikov's rule, and this is very important in order to know which is formed in major amounts when the addition is taking place, as electrophilic addition is taking place to unsymmetrical alkenes. So this is what is Morkonikov's rule. In order to know the orientation of addition, this rule is very important here in the case of unsymmetrical alkenes. So the first one, the electrophilic addition, is the addition of HCl, that is HBr, HCl or HI. We take that as let's see this mechanism in detail now. So the first step, we are taking, suppose here, butene here, the addition of HBr to this is the HX here, for example. Then the first one is protonation of the double bond, or the electrophile adding of the pi bond to the electrophile. Now the H plus will attack, resulting in the formation of the carbocation in the first step. See, the double bond will attack here, and the Br is taken out, resulting in the formation of carbocation with a positive charge. And in the second step, the Br minus now will attack on this carbocation, resulting in the formation of alkyl halide here. Yes, alkyl halide is being formed by the electrophilic addition. So if this is an unsymmetrical alkene, it follows the Morkonikov's rule. Let's see that in the case of propene now, which is unsymmetrical alkene here. The previous slide I've explained this. Let's see this in detail now. When the addition is taking place, the electrophilic addition in the first step will take place in such a way that it produces the more stable carbocation. So the H plus may attack here or here, but if it is attacking here, if the pi bond is adding here, so this is the primary carbocation which is produced, and this is the secondary carbocation which is produced. But we know that this is the primary carbocation. The order of the stability of the carbocations is tertiary, more stable than secondary, then comes primary. So as primary is less stable than secondary, this is unstable, so formed in minor amounts, and this is more stable, so formed in major amounts. A secondary carbocation is more stable because of the inductive effect we can see here. So because of the inductive effect of these two methyl groups, it's but here it's only one ethyl group which is present here. It's a primary carbocation, so this is unstable and so formed in minor amounts here. So when the nucleophilic attack is taking place in the second step, that the Br- minus now added to the primary carbocation. Here it is added to the secondary carbocation. So, and this results in the major product, that is 2-bromopropane is a major product which is observed when compared to that of the 1-bromopropane, which is a minor product, which is observed during the addition of HBr to propene, that is unsymmetrical alkenes. This is the first step is a slow step, so the rate determining step of the reaction, and the second step is the fast step here, we can see here. Yes, so depending upon the stability of the carbocation, we can arrive at the product, and this can be known by the Morkonikov's rule, which says that the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon with less number of hydrogens. So we can check with that also. This bromine, that is Br minus, this is the negative part of HBr. So this is going to the carbon with less number of hydrogens. This is a major product having less number of hydrogens. Yes. When we take few more examples of this, in this case, when HBr is added to this unsymmetrical alkene, this is a major product which is formed. This is because the carbocation which is produced is when H plus is can be added here or here, depending upon so formation of two carbocations. We know that this carbocation, that's a tertiary carbocation, is more stable than secondary. So this one is formed in major amounts when compared to that of this secondary product here. And when we take this as an example here, yes, this unsymmetrical alkenes, 2-methylpropene or isobutene we are taking here, right? When HBr is being added, this one is a tertiary here. So the Br is being added here. Here it's only primary carbon. Two types of carbocations are possible. One is primary and one is tertiary here. We know that tertiary is more stable than primary. So 2-bromo-2-methylpropane is the major product which is absorbed when compared to that of the primary alkyl halide here. Yes, we have seen this in detail with the examples. Now let's see the addition of water now to alkenes. Addition of water to alkenes takes place in the presence of strongly acid catalyst like H2SO4. So it requires the acid catalyst like H2SO4. So in the presence of acids, it takes place, resulting in the formation of an alcohol. For example, when we add water to ethylene, we get ethanol. This takes place in the presence of strongly acidic catalyst like H2SO4. And H and OH are added to the adjacent carbons here. So again, this follows the Morkonikov's rule, where the negative part of the addendum goes to the carbon with less number of hydrogens if we take the unsymmetrical alkenes here. Let's see the mechanism of this hydration in detail now. First of all, when we take this, when we take the mechanism of this hydration, in the first step is the protonation of the double bond to form the carbocation. So, resulting in the formation of this carbocation. And in the next step, the nucleophilic attack of the water. The water will attack on this carbocation. And in the third step is the deprotonation, where the proton is removed here to water, resulting in the formation of hydronium ion, and the H or OH are added to the adjacent carbon atoms, resulting in the formation of an alcohol here. So in the first step is the protonation, where proton is added to one of the carbons, resulting in the formation of carbocation. In the next step is the addition of water. And the third step is the deprotonation. There's a removal of H+, resulting in the formation of an alcohol here. Yes. And when we see with the help of an example, this hydration, for example, if we take this alkene, this is an unsymmetrical alkene, 2-methyl-2-butene. First step is the protonation here. So the proton may be added here or here, but we know that the carbocation which is produced here is a tertiary carbocation, which is more stable when compared to that of this secondary carbocation. So this is more stable tertiary carbocation, and we know that this less stable secondary carbocation. So when the next step, when the nucleophilic attack take place, followed by the removal of this or the deprotonation, results in the two products, which is one is major and the other one is minor. The major is the tertiary alcohol and the minor one is the secondary alcohol here. So depending upon the stability of the carbocations, the alcohols are formed in unequal amounts. One is major and the minor, and the formation of this, which is major, can be predicted based on this Morkonikov's rule. Yes. And next one is this hydration by oxymercuration followed by demercuration. So a reaction in which the alkene is reacted with this Hg2+ salt in the presence of water results in the formation of an organomercury intermediate. This intermediate, when treated with NaBH4 here, that is sodium borohydride, the carbon hydrogen bond, this one is converted to the carbon hydrogen bond here. So the carbon mercury bond is broken and the carbon hydrogen bond is formed here. So when this alkene is treated with this Hg2+ salt in the presence of water, resulting in the formation of an intermediate, that is organomercury intermediate, which on further treatment with sodium borohydride, the carbon mercury bond is broken and the carbon hydride bond is formed. So the overall reaction is the conversion of this alkene to alcohol, where the water is acting as a nucleophile here, this OH-. Yes, next one. Let's see this mechanism in detail now. The first step is the electrophilic attack to form the mercurium ion. A pi bond will attack on this, resulting in the formation of mercurium ion. This is called as mercurium ion here. This is mercurium ion. And this water in the next step will open this mercurium ion. The little bit of electrons on this O minus will attack on this carbon atom, and this will be taken away, resulting in the formation of this particular product, where it loses the H+ in the second step, resulting in the formation of this intermediate, which is nothing but organomercurium intermediate. And in the next step now, when treated with sodium borohydride here, then NaBH4+4OH-, now this is a hydride donor here, NaBH4, and this bond is broken, and CH bond is being formed, and NaBOH4 is being given out here. So for example, when this unsymmetrical alkene, when treated with water, HCOA taken twice followed by sodium borohydride, this is a hydride donor, resulting in the formation of this particular alcohol, which is nothing but major product, that is, this is a tertiary alcohols, which is major here, and when it attack place take place, this is secondary here, which is a minor product. So major product is the tertiary alcohol, which is formed here. Again, can be the major product, the formation can be predicted based on this Morkonikov's rule here. Yes.